Please, poets and peers, pardon my obsession with peace in this portion, but this peace is meant to bring you peace as I preach on the problem of the day. Prayer is the key, as they say. It's the life buoy that keeps us afloat on Christ, boy. It gives us that spiritual cleansing. Look how repentance has made us so clean. Prayer is preceded by teaching. Teachings found in the good book that tell us of his kingdom. The same good books that tell us to be stationary in the word. The word that serves as our telephone line to the Father. Prayer is supposed to keep us on fire for God, aglow for Jesus. But lately, things have been a little dark, dim, low. I know relationships are about communication. But my all-day texts have become a cliche, good morning, thanking you for life. Relationships are about trust, but I've become a regular cheating wife. Married to Christ, but still walking dead, a zombie in sin. Always regretting, but I still live because the groom is the one that made a dead man walk again. Lazarus was pit against death and he rose up victorious. Yet I don't know why I held back my voice. Maybe it was my ego that kept me from reaching the alpha, or maybe it was the fruit from the garden. Maybe it was too big, so it choked me, kept me from reaching the mighty healer. It choked me, kept me from shouting in a loud voice, Master, I need you. It choked me, kept me from touching the tips of your garment to get my salvation. They say this love, it choked, but I didn't see it coming. It choked me, suffocated me. Drowning out the words of prayer I cooked up in my imagination for you. I had your mark of salvation, but I still marked time, waiting for the 11th hour to submit the teacher's assignment, not watching, waiting for the last moment to be the perfect child. Prayer is supposed to be like the late night calls you have with your partner. Intimate. Intimate, how we pray to be intimate with the Father, and yet we choose a box with a screen over talking to the boxer in our corner. Unfortunate. We choose a box with a screen over talking to the one who watches your life like his box office. Misfortune hits, and we choose a box with a screen for talking to the one who fought for our salvation. I don't think you see the problem. We have broken up communication with him. Our Christian mark no longer pushes us to find X, and you don't see why that is a problem. It's about time. It's about time we stop procrastinating our conversation with our PRO, public relations officer. He is our advocate. He carries your case in court, our lawyer, the name through which we pray. That man, he's more than capable. He literally carried your sins on the cross. He is the word that carries your word to the Father. So why should your problems weigh too much for the way? I mean, a guy doesn't need a motor for him to travel to Tema. He's already the way. He made the way. If not, then why else would we sing the song Waymaker? Sorry. I think I was sidetracked a little. Distracted by selfish ambitions, it caused me to sideline the Lord, but only for a little while though. Now let's get back on track. We need an answer. We say we want answers, but we don't ask enough questions. Can you not see? Can you not see how the lack of prayer is hurting your life? We are at war, a war of spirits. So how do you fight the spiritual war? We are both armed and unarmed. We are both armed and unarmed. Your tongue is a literal weapon. Your words are sharper than a double-edged sword, yet you do not pray. You do not find time to utilize your God-given utility, so the devil preys on you while you lay defenseless. He attacks family, finance. Fortunately, your prayer bank hasn't run out yet. Maybe that's why you're still fine. Not seeing how average your lifestyle is. If your life was graded, you would have a C, minus all the mistakes yet to come. They say time is relative, but watch me. Read my lips. We need to watch and pray. We need to keep awake, awake. The Lord did not die in vain. Do not go a day without a word to the Father. Start each morning with the Father, I thank you, and end it with the Father, I thank you. Let the rise of the sun mark the rise of your words to the sun. Let your fire keep burning like a snap streak as you snap to the tune of his word each day. Hashtag as we pray, let's start a new trend. Do not go a day without a chat with the Father. Start each day with a daily WhatsApp to the King of Kings, and remember to watch at night, because TikTok, the trend is here. TikTok, the end is near.